What's up, guys? This is the last episode of our Action Cable chat series, and the feature that we're going to be adding in this last episode takes advantage of the same page visibility API that we used in the notification one. And the reason why we're going to use that is because we want to keep track of the last time that you looked at the chat so that you can see the unread messages that you haven't seen yet. So we're going to use the page visibility API to keep track of, are you looking at this page or not? And then we will insert a horizontal row, kind of like this one, into the page, and then any new messages will get put under there until you come back and look at it. In which case, when you come back, we'll remove that row, and then we will send a message to the server saying that the current time is when you last read all of the messages. So we'll keep track of this time, and that time will be the one that determines any of the messages made before that time have been seen, and any of them after that time have not been seen. So we'll keep track of that timestamp, and then anytime a new message comes over, we will check to see if you were looking at this page or not, and then we'll send a message to the server saying, I read that message, if you are, and if you're not, we'll wait until you come back, and then we'll tell the server that you're looking at that message. So this should be pretty straightforward, but it's one of those features that's a little bit complicated to wrap your head around. It's a lot more straightforward than you might think. So we'll create a new channel to keep track of that so that the browser can tell the server when you last read the message, because this is not a feature that should be built server side, because the only person who can actually know if you read it or not is you. So when you take an action and we can detect that you did that, then we can update the server and let them know that that's the last most recent time that you read those messages. So we're going to take advantage of that visibility API to keep track of whether or not you were looking at this window or not. So this is going to be what we're going to do, and let's just dive in. So the first thing that we need to do is that we need to create a migration to add that to our database. So that timestamp is going to be important, and we're going to need to add that. If you remember back to the beginning of this series, we created a chat room users model. And so we're going to create our migration to add last read at, let's make sure that's a capital L, add last read at to chat room users, and last read at date time is the column name and type. So this chat room users table is used specifically to join users to chat rooms. So when you click the join button to go into a chat room, we create this record, and that way we know that you're permanently actively participating in that chat. So that's how we keep track of the chat rooms that you have joined in the menu. And this is going to be added to that so that every single chat room you are a part of, you specifically, will be able to keep track of that timestamp. Now, if we did this any other way, that timestamp would apply to all channels or all users or anything like that, and that would be kind of messy. Now, the other option would be that we could put the timestamp on the messages individually, but there's almost no reason to go do that, at least for our application, because we don't want you to ever have messages in the past that were all read except for this one and maybe this one. It would be weird for a user experience. So we want to just say everything before this time has been read and everything after this time has not been read. If we go to the message level and we say that every single user has a read timestamp for every single message, that's a whole ton of data that we don't need to save, because it doesn't really add any benefits to our user experience, and that's a ton of data. So that would be tons and tons and tons of records in the database for every single message and every single user for every single message. So you end up sort of storing exponentially more data based on how many messages would be sent. So that would be a bad data model for this problem. So let's go ahead and create this migration, run rakedb migrate. And now we're going to need to dive into the JavaScript and create our active record, our action cable channel, in order to keep track of this server side. But first, we're going to need to modify our JavaScript when new messages come in before we trigger that.